Hello, I'm Chris Menard. I have a great video on how to sort in Excel. I'm going to cover 7 items about sorting in this video. We're going to take a look at checking your data, sorting by one column, sorting by multiple columns, how to sort by color, how to sort by months, how you can create a custom sort, and the last item is what happens when you try to sort numbers that have numbers and text on the same column. We'll take a look at that. There are chapters down below. Feel free to click. Let's dive into this video right now. So the very first thing we're going to do is how to check your data in Excel. You should not have any blank rows or blank columns. Usually, when I put an Excel file together, I don't have to do this step, but I always do it when someone sends me a file to look at. So click inside your data. Control A on the keyboard is not select all. It is select the current range I'm in. So Control A, it highlighted the range I'm in, and then do Control Period. Control period will jump you from the top left corner to the top right corner to the very bottom right, very bottom left, and you can keep going around. In real life, I do have only 36 rows, but once I'm at the bottom here, grab your mouse, scroll down, and just make sure there's no other rows down here with a bunch of empty blank rows, because that would be bad. So my data is good here. In case you're wondering, I'm going to click on another worksheet just to show you this. It looks the same data. Control A, though, if you notice, only picked up part of the range. I'm going to come back and talk about why in just one second. So let's discuss sorting by one column, and here's my test. I'm actually going to highlight the row that I'm in and put a yellow background there. If you want to sort by one column, we know that all the data is together. I want to sort by state. Just right-click any state. It doesn't matter where. Go to sort, and then there are your sort options. I'm going to do a sort A to Z. It sorted California before Georgia, so it's working correctly. Notice the row I put in yellow is all together. One more sort. I'm going to sort by purchases to date. I'm in a number column, so it's going to say smallest to largest or largest to smallest. If you don't like the right-click method, click one time anywhere you want to in a column. Sort is so popular that it's on 2 different tabs, including the right-click, which I just did. It's on the Home tab. Over here in the far right in the Editing group is Sort and Filter. A to Z is exactly the same as the right-click trick I just did. I'm going to click it. So I sorted by source A to Z. You want to sort in descending order, there is Z to A. It's also on the data tab right here is A to Z. Let's do this one real quick. I'm going to go back to state, A to Z. So sort is all over the place. I usually do it with the right click or I come to the data tab, but it is on the home tab in the editing group. Next item, I wanted to show you why this got messed up. I see people doing this all the time. Apparently, when they went to print this, they did not like that invoice date and source were right next to each other. And I see people doing this occasionally. This is a big no-no. They add a blank column with absolutely nothing in it. So now what would happen, by the way, I just want to show you this. If I come in here and say, yeah, let's go do a sort by state. Watch this. My data is incorrect now as far as looking at it. So don't ever sort someone else's data without doing the Control A and Control Period trick. So I'm not going to mess with this worksheet anymore. It is broken. Could fix it by deleting that column. Let's keep on moving. If you want to sort by multiple columns, I am going to get rid of this yellow here right now. We know that it's correct. Go to the Data tab. This is where I usually do this at, is Sort. If you don't like going to Data Sort, again, you can right click. Sort, and there is custom sort. I'm going to come right up here. Excel is smart enough in this dialog box that appears to know that my data has headers. Always make your header row bold. If you're going to do other stuff to it, italics, a font color, you can, but always make it bold. So I want to sort by state first, then by city. I would also like to sort by source, household type. I'm going to stop here in just a second. And finally, maybe purchases to date. I have not changed any of these. They've all been A to Z, A to Z, A to Z. Now I've got numbers and I'm going to sort these largest to smallest. In Excel, in the past, many years ago, three items were all you could sort by. You can sort by 64 items, by the way. In case you're wondering what happens if you add a field and put it in the wrong place, you would just swap it right here with these arrows, but I did have it correctly, state, city. If you want to lose something, you click on and hit delete level. So I'm going to sort by these five items right here. Click on OK. California did show up first. If you notice, San Diego in column D showed up before San Francisco. Within San Diego, I've got two LinkedIn before one magazine, so that is correct. Also, then we did household type. If you look right here at Athens, Georgia, Google Ads, family showed up before single. And if you look also at income, purchases to date, the 620 showed up before the 550 because we said sort that largest to smallest. So there was our sort, data sort, and it did work. Just pointing that out. Next item I want to discuss is you can sort by color. I'm just going to stay here again. I'm just going to manually put, I'm on the home tab. I click someone's last name. And I'm going to use a yellow fill color. That is normally the default, but I've been in here playing, so there's yellow. And maybe the people in yellow I need to call next week. I'll do one more. I don't care who you click on. Let's do a different color. People in green, either a coworker I want to call, be responsible for calling these people, or I need to call them in 2 weeks. And then finally, one last person in a different color. That works. You can sort by color. Data tab, sort. I did want to do this. I'm going to sit here and delete every one of these levels. I still have a header row, add a level. I want to sort by last name, but here you go. I do want to sort by not the font color, the cell color. If I would have used the font color that was next to the paint can, I could have done font color, but everything's cell color. Excel is smart enough to know the colors I used. I'm going to pick yellow, and I want it to be on top. Now I want to sort by the green. I don't have to click Add Level again. I could. I'm just going to select Copy Level. Last name, green. One more Add Level. Oops, sorry. One more Copy Level. Last name, blue. Just to test this, right now everything is showing up on top. I'm going to put the blue on the bottom. So I should have yellow, followed by the green, followed by a bunch of records with no color, because I haven't done the last name in color, and then the blue should be at the bottom. When I click OK, exactly what I was expecting. So there is sort by color. So we've done checking our data, we've done a sort by one column, we've done a sort by multiple columns, we've done a sort by color. Let's go and do a sort by month right now. I'm on the worksheet called Sorting. We're going to do a sort by month. I intentionally put column G in that yellow background. I want to sort by month. I'm on the data tab. Here's A to Z. I click it. I've got April abbreviated, followed by August, followed by December. So it did work, but that is not what I'm expecting. If you want to sort by month, January through December, you can come in here to custom sort. Still, the header row is month they became a client. But I want to do what's called a custom list sort. January, comma, Feb, because I've got three-letter months in here. If I had them spelled out, it'd be this next one. Click on OK. Click on OK, and there is sorting by month. Back into sort again. If you notice in my custom list, I do want to mention this. The very first one right here through the 1, 2, 3, the fourth one down are already set up when you have Microsoft Excel installed. I've added these other two. These are called custom sort lists that you can do. Let's go do one for a month starting in October and ending in September. And that would be because someone's calendar year and fiscal year are not the same. The calendar year will start in January. The fiscal year will start in October. So here's how you set this up. It's up to you whether you do a three-letter abbreviation for the month or spell it out. I'm just going to do the abbreviation. I've got my crosshairs for autofill in the bottom right. I'm going to pull down until I get to September and let go. Leave that selected. To add this to your custom list sort, you go to File and Options. File is up in the top left. Go to Options. When you go into File Options, you want to go to Advanced over on the left and scroll down all the way to the bottom. And here is Edit Custom List. It's in the General group. And the reason I left it highlighted is I can import it now. So notice over to the left here, the custom list that I already have. Again, the first four were set up by the people from Excel. I did the next two. But here comes my third one. When I hit import, there we go. Click OK. Click OK. You can delete what I have in column M now. You don't need that anymore. Click back in the column you want to sort by. Go to Sort, Custom List. And now, there we go. Our fiscal year is October through September. Click OK. And click OK, and there's an October through September sort. Another item to mention about custom sort is it doesn't have to be months. It could be products. Maybe you want to see three products always sorted first before you see another five or six products that your company has. Last item we have to do is sort by text and numbers. Great, great tip I'm about to give you here. So if I'm looking and say, you know, I wonder what the sum is of the purchases to date, and I highlight them, whoops, through I-36, let's do that one more time, I-2 through I-36 and press enter, 26,820. So the same way that I started this session off doing control A and control period to find a range, if someone sends me data, I would first highlight it if I'm about to do numbers. And I'm going to look down in the bottom right corner in the status bar. It always tells you the sum, the count, and the average. This is a tip you should do immediately. You right-click the word sum. Within this area right here, I've got average down to sum. Go ahead and check every one of these items right here. They will be turned on forever for every worksheet on that computer that you're using. So it's by computer. So I immediately know now, not only what's the average and the sum, I know the maximum, the minimum, but notice I've got count and I've got numerical count. Count is counting every cell that has something in it. Very similar to the count A function. Numerical count is the count function, which only counts numbers. So I can quickly tell I have text and numbers in the same column. And therefore, this number actually is incorrect. I've got some text fields in here. I've covered this before, and I'll put that video link down below on how to quickly identify text cells. But I'm just going to change this real quick to numbers with one of my favorite tricks. I'm going to type the number 1 and do Control Enter. I'm going to copy that number 1. I'm going to highlight everything that should be a number, including those text items that look like numbers. Right click, paste special. I did the number 1 and I copied it. I right clicked, paste special, and I want to multiply everything I see by the number 1. I'm going to hit OK. Before I hit OK, take a look in the bottom right. I have 25 numerical counts and 35 counts. Hit OK, and now I've got a perfect match of 35 and 35. That is what I was looking for. Also, the sum went from 25 or 26,000 to 35,066. That is perfect. So that is a cool tip, changing text to numbers, using the number one and multiplying them. And there you go. By the way, I am going to do an undo, Control Z. The problem with having text and numbers in a column is when you go and sort it, you usually get a sort warning. Let's see if we do. See, we didn't even get the sort warning, but there you go. It did identify the text here. Text usually is identified with a green triangle. Also, usually it's to the left aligned, but happens to be right aligned here. So this is where you could get in trouble. So that's why I'm doing this. One other cool tip, if you don't like the number one, just click here and say, hey, it's numbers stored as text, but these really need to be numbers. Convert them to numbers too. This is another way right here. Again, I'm pointing out that everything is matching again. I hope you enjoyed this video. I enjoyed making it because sorting is one of the most popular Excel features. Feel free to subscribe, ring the bell. Any comments or questions, put them down below. Have a wonderful day. Thank you.